In this video, you will learn to create contingency tables from summary data using StatCrunch. The data set I am using is called pairwise counts for categorical variables. This consists of a contingency table loaded directly into the StatCrunch data table. The table shows 6 values of A that are paired with 4 values of C and 2 values of D. The 4 B values are paired with 2 values of C and 2 values of D. To analyze the summary data, under the Stat menu, choose Tables, Contingency, with Summary. We need to select both the C and the D columns. To do so, hold down Command on a Mac or Control on a PC. In Row Labels, choose the var1 column. And for Column Label, type in var2. I'll now click Compute. The resulting contingency table shows the original table, as well as the row-wise totals, the column-wise totals, and the total number of pairs. The output also shows the results of a standard chi-square test for independence. Since the cell counts are low, in this case, a warning message is displayed for the test results. I will discuss a better alternative for this data later in the video. StatCrunch also allows additional information to be displayed in the contingency table. To view the different options, under the Options menu, choose Edit. This will take us back to the original window where we built our contingency table. In this window, StatCrunch has other options for the user to customize their contingency table. Under the Display options, you will see the different options that can be added. For this example, I will choose Row Percent and click Compute. Now the resulting table shows that 2/3, 66.6% of the A values are paired with the C values, and 1/3, 33.3%, are paired with the D values. The table shows a 50-50 split between the C and D pairings for the B values. As mentioned prior, the chi-square test is not appropriate for this data due to the small cell counts. StatCrunch offers a number of tests that can be computed from the contingency table output. To view these, back under Options, there is a box labeled Hypothesis Tests. Note, some of these tests can only be restricted to a 2x2 table. They are labeled accordingly. For this example, I'm going to deselect the chi-square test for independence and choose the Fisher's exact test for independence. Also notice further down in the window, StatCrunch can also calculate confidence intervals. For this example, I'm not going to select the confidence interval option. Now click Compute, and the resulting output shows the new results for the Fisher's exact test.